All right, welcome back to another episode of A Noob Plays NBA 2K18, and we're just gonna go right out to the court and get a game in really quick.
Whoa, 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 what are you doing?
I'm giving you a leg up. The other team smells you wearing cologne and gets them guessing. Why is he wearing cologne?
Oh, that's good thinking. Let me get a hit. Ah, that cheap stuff.
Yeah, you feel me?
I'm feeling you.
Same. Y'all go out and bring home the win.
All right. Thank you for the cologne. Boo-boo, man. Something wrong with that guy. Let's go. Scotty D is the starting center. He's ready to roll. Let's go.
Pretty clear. Is it possible for a team to suddenly kick into a high gear?
And all right, I win the first half, and that's a good start.
Different the second half of the season.
You know, sometimes a tweak of the lineup, a guy
out because
of injury.
Why did they try to go under the basket?
It can definitely kickstart a lot of teams, and you just start to play better. The one thing
is,
when
start
you start to hit that chemistry, that continuity, and everything is clicking on self.
All right, we get the steal.
Yes, you can. You can have
we're
it
on the break.
Mid-season.
So let's take a look at the Boston Celtics starting
nothing
lineup.
But net.
Kyrie Irving is out there with Smart. And there's the monster, and it's Hayward, and it's Horford in at the four spot. Levine dishes to Mirotic. Now here's Lopez, guarded closer.
No, give me that board,
Grant.
I want it.
And so it's Boston with it. They put up a nice win against Detroit the last time out.
I tell you what, how efficient they were at scoring the
basketball, right,
especially for an away game. That was impressive.
They did a good job of controlling the tempo, playing at a speed that suits their offense.
Kicks to Lopez. Grant the pass to Bondexter. Mirotić the screen.
Where you go.
Three-pointer. Horford with the rebound. For Boston, they've gone 2-3 here to start out the game. Irving kicks to Horford. Jacks up a three. Kept alive by Bender. Smart passes to the monster. The kick out to Irving. And here in the first, closing in on 2 minutes play. Here's Smart. 9 points last game out. Here's the monster.
Go get it.
The layup off target.
That's one of those,
man,
where you think you've got it. You relax.
Come on.
A second, and then you're kicking yourself.
Outside, Levine. Feeds it to Mirotić. That's good, and it's Levine with the assist. Mirotić is
Let's
got
go.
Himself going there. His first points of the game on the deep ball. Irving kicks to Hayward. Pass to the monster. In the corner, Smart with it. From beyond the arc. Offensive rebound.
What? Where did I pass it?
Second shot opportunity. And there's the foul on the shot. He'll go to the line for two.
Why did I pass that? Hit the wrong
daggone
button.
The Celtics shoot their first free throws. First trip to the line
That's
in
right.
this one.
And typically, a strength of theirs, 79% on the season.
Free throw drop for Al Horford.
And Al Horford, just so versatile. You know, that extends to the defensive end as well. Very mobile, can move his feet with smaller players, and at the same time, gives you a presence on the interior.
It's a luxury to have a big man who can shoot free throws this way.
Mirotić, the screen. Grant dishes to Mirotić. Can't tie it up as that one misses. And Horford won't wow you with his athleticism, but Greg, he's still a pretty good shot blocker.
He has great timing, anticipation, and awareness.
All right.
Don't forget also, he's got terrific
good pass.
Hands.
Thank you.
And you see that with all the steals he racks up.
Grant against Irving. Grant the pass to Levine, launches a three, buries it from three-point range. Levine's got himself on the board with three there.
Tough to challenge Levine out there. Big lift on his shot, and you must close out quicker on him.
And out of bounds is Chicago gets possession. Just a moment to look back at how things were last season for this team as we look at the shot breakdown for the Celtics.
And the three-point shot was a huge part of their game plan. When it was falling, it made them very hard to defend. Opponents were stretched out all over the place.
Grant gets a wide-open look. Chance there to take the lead.
Another ball.
The Celtics with the lead. Hayward kicks to Smart. To the inside. Here's the monster. Good.
There we go. Soft touch.
The monster's got six.
A guy who converts well at the rim, you like to see the aggression there.
You really like him setting the tone early. Physical, challenging guys to stop.
What?
And the officials call
travel. Oh, okay. He traveled. I thought he called me a foul.
Let's use this break to look at the teams that over the past month have been tremendous at converting turnovers into points. Number one, the Celtics. Fourth, the Bulls.
Both of these teams are going to have to really take care of the basketball because they're both making a killing scoring off those turnovers.
Hayward passes to the monster. The dish to Horford, and there's the feed to Smart. The Celtics working the ball around now. Outside Irving. Back to Horford. This one for three. Off to a good start as he hits his first shot attempt.
And there's where, if you get some room, you kind of have to take that shot to keep the defense honest.
Lopez a screen. Horford against Mirotić. Grant dishes to LaVine. Trying to come right back with the three of his own, but it's no good. Irving with the ball. He's been patient so far. Nothing yet on the scoreboard. He dishes it to Hayward. In the corner, Irving with it. Six to shoot. Five in the act of shooting. A three-point play chance coming up.
The monster just about mauled him there.
Has been fantastic and is a big part of why they've been able to get these good looks.
First trip to the free throw line for him tonight. Bobby Portis has checked in for Quincy Pondexter.
My best buddy, Kyrie Irving.
And with all the talk about Kyrie coming to Boston, you still have to figure how he'll fit in to the team. Has this year and next
year. All right, we're up by 10.
Contract, player option after that. But with his scoring and shooting, should make this offense even more potent.
And the first timeout of the game called for Chicago.
And when you put a player of Kyrie's ability into this Boston system, you have to expect good things. Irving does so much for himself and others. The longer he plays with the team, I think the more comfortable he'll become.
And Mirotić has it in the corner. And no good. The dry spell continuing for him.
Ooh, man, I am tearing up the boards.
You're Smart. And that one comes up a bit short.
And that was an easy one there. Just a missed opportunity. If you give it to him, he'll take that shot every time.
There you go, Kyrie.
The floor. I'm sure he's kicking himself.
Here's the monster.
Oh, get it.
It's all done by the Bulls. A tough loss coming against New York in their last game played.
Yeah, you hate losing a game that you control for three quarters. That was just really
man, how did they get that?
In terms of how they played. And unfortunately, they took it out.
There's a screen. Irving from long range.
Woo-hoo.
Sinks the three-pointer. Irving's got six.
The quickness of Kyrie off the pick makes him hard to stick with defensively.
They've been looking out of sync offensively.
Yeah, their offense has ground to a standstill.
Get out of the zone, man. Get
LaVine. Again, LaVine missing.
And they've come out with a take no prisoners approach on the glass here tonight, guys.
And that right. One's good, Irving.
He's been locked in all quarter, really finding his rhythm.
Grant kicks to Portis. Pass to Lopez. Baseline.
No way.
That's on the jump shot.
No way, dude. Nice
the way
shot.
Lopez finished with a guy right on him, shows incredible confidence on his part.
Irving kicks to Hayward. To the wing on the left. Now here's Smart, covered by Mirotić. To the middle. Lopez with the steal. No good from the Monster.
Lacking confidence right now in his offense. He's been shaky all period.
Levine. Good work defensively by Horford.
Obviously, this has been a tough quarter for him, but he's still trying to keep a positive mindset.
Doesn't go that time.
Pretty good shot.
Grant against Irving. Grant kicks to Miritich.
Oh.
With the first shot clock. Grant outside. Lopez a screen.
There's a whole lot I could do about allowing that one.
Back to Miritich. From deep.
Rebound. Give me that. Boston.
Well, Monster's got his eighth rebound here tonight.
That's ninth, buddy. Come on. Oh, man.
Outside Irving.
Right, Irving's got to put on a show. We get a
doesn't go for him. And Chicago will go the other way with the
okay.
ball.
Okay. Gotta give Irving his due. Let him do what he wants Grant. To do sometimes. He wasn't gonna pass that no matter what on that one.
And there's a minute 45 left in the first quarter. Levine. And again, Chicago.
Another board.
I'll tell you, he just hasn't been able to get it done on the offensive end. He's kind of dragged down the team.
And this is one of those times where the coach has gotta preach. Be unselfish. And we don't know that he hasn't. Maybe it's been falling on deaf ears. Guys taking ill-advised jump shots. And, you know, not sure if it's him or the defense, but just something's off tonight.
Especially in this quarter. He's had a few shots that look like they were.
Oh,
falling.
Come on. Man, I'm cold. His way.
Just hasn't had
his I'm hot, but I don't feel like I'm hot, man. I'm missing a lot of shots. The boards, I'm hot.
Mirotic, the pass to Levine. Fires from deep.
Nope.
Again, Levine missing.
Oh, the defense fortunate there.
Ooh, 12 rebounds already.
To leave wide open.
Inside. Here's the Monster.
Pass it.
In the corner, Horford with it. Now, here's Irving. He had 16 points in the win against Detroit. Shot clock at 5. Here's Hayward. Their offense, stone cold. Another miss there.
Come on, man. We're up by 11 and we're not hitting.
The shot clock and game clock. And stolen by Kyrie Irving. Shot off the pick. And the shot is long. Levine wide open. Again, Levine missing.
And the defense daring him to shoot that good play.
He had 13 rebounds in that quarter.
Performance for Kyrie Irving. He has been the story for the Boston Celtics. He notched 8 points in the quarter and has that terrific basketball instinct on display. We'll get right back to the action when we return.
All right, let's go.
A close game so some changes for Chicago.
Oh, they tied it up.
Lopez is checked in for Felicio. Miritich comes in for Markkanen.
What the hell happened? I was on the bench.
And you look at this Celtics roster, a bevy of long athletic
offensive foul.
They seem to be taking a cue from teams like the Warriors, who have found success with defensive switching and positionless basketball.
We've got Nikola Miritich. Grant is out there with Valentine. Then there's Robin Lopez, and it's Portis in at the power forward. So that's the 5 in the game for Chicago. And let's catch up with our sideline reporter, David Aldridge.
Hey, Kevin. Well, the Monster in the last game against the Pistons was a driven man. He ended up with 19 points.
You should have passed it when I wanted you to pass it.
Piled up rebound after rebound. The numbers in that game make me anxious to see what he can do tonight. Kevin?
Thanks, David, for another reminder of just what an unbelievable performance that was.
One that everyone's still talking about tonight. He dominated that game in just about every way possible.
I'm so excited. I can't wait to see what he's got in store for us tonight. Maybe he tops himself again. I think he just might do it.
Irving from long range. The shot's good. Right. On the assist by Horford. Horford's got 3 assists in the game.
And the Celtics, as you see, are stockpiling wing forwards. Brown, Tatum, Hayward, and we're seeing those guys lining up at the 2, 3, and 4. It gives Brad Stevens tremendous roster versatility.
You know, and I'll tell you, he's got nothing here in the second quarter after just one made shot in the first.
And it's sent back by Lopez.
And that is the length of Robin Lopez on display.
Grant dishes to Valentine. Knocks it loose and stolen by Kyrie Irving.
Go.
Here's Abrines, and he goes up strong with one hand and flushes it down.
Well, that's why they're in front. Aggressive play at both ends. Nicely done.
Now Valentine. He's got 11. Lopez a screen, and Mirotić has it in the corner. No good on the triple.
Not sure why he keeps trying his luck from deep here. It's just not his night.
Irving with a clean look. But they recover it. Tries again. Chicago
quick.
Grabs the miss.
Very late.
Portis has got his fourth rebound in this one. Mirotić against Hayward. Grant kicks to Lopez. And good, and it takes a nice bounce off the right iron and down. Lopez has got 4 this quarter.
Well, Lopez knew he had space to get that shot off. He was ready for it.
Irving kicks to Hayward. Out to the wing. They set the pick to the left wing. Shot clock at 6. Throws it down.
Oh, there we go.
Right in his face. A chance here for a 3-point play.
And that's how it's done. I mean, find that hole in the D and then go hard to the rack.
Maybe that hole was a little bigger than it should have been.
It looked like a total breakdown to me there. He exploited that hole perfectly and made them pay.
Marcus Smart's check in for the
second. There we go.
That free throw good from the monster.
And they have yet to miss a shot from the line here this quarter.
And stolen by Hayward. Unloads from 13. And he gets the friendly spin, and that one drops. Smart's got his first 2 points.
And good passing, setting up a lot of these buckets right now, Kevin. That's been the key.
Justin Mirotić, here's the 3, and the 3 ball is good.
A tough start scoring the basketball, but they're starting to turn it around now.
Irving kicks to Smart. Here's the monster, and he
does. Give me that.
And he's now got the double-double. 11
points. Another double-double.
16 rebounds.
Another one in the first
half. As forceful a finish as you're ever going to see out of this guy.
Well, gee, it adds now to their lead in spectacular fashion.
That's about as violent as a rim rocker as it gets. A real confidence builder.
6 on the shot clock. Some nice
ball
movement by the ball.
Oh, that's
the
my bad.
Good from Lopez.
My bad.
It started hot, and he's only gotten harder.
And here's Irving. He's got 14. They set the screen. And
there we go.
Celtics with another basket.
And once Kyrie gets in rhythm, he's flat out unstoppable at scoring the basketball.
Here's Mirotić. And again, it's the Bulls from deep.
Well, this is where we're going in the NBA right now. Stretch big.
Put it up.
Ooh. What a performance.
All right,
half
time.
Irving. He has been the story for Boston. He ends up dropping in 2 from distance, making a difference from long. After the break,
all right, let's
we'll
go see how
right
we did
back
at the half. All right, 11 points, 16 rebounds. That's amazing. 2 steals. Got an A-plus. Stop free rolling out there when we have the ball. Keep it simple and run the pick and roll. We have success with that, so don't try to fix what isn't broken. All right, coach.
The third quarter now beginning. Both sides looking to pull away in the last
half. Let's
go. You look at Kyrie Irving in this game. He has been everywhere.
And through the first 2 quarters, he was extremely aggressive. Picked up a number of steals.
He did a nice job reading their plays as they were developing. His anticipation was off the charts.
And now let's check out the lineups courtesy of Gatorade, all fueled up and ready to go for the second half of basketball. On the court for the Celtics, Hayward out there with Horford. Then there's Irving. Then there's Smart, and it's the monster in the center filling out the middle.
How is that a bad thing? Look, he threw it behind me.
Now guarded by Smart. Pondexter kicks to Grant. And with the zone defenses the league allows right now, motion offense really becoming a key to efficient scoring, it seems, Steve. Do you like that trend?
I do, because it's really hard. They're taking advantages of the rules. Zone defense is hard to be able to stop teams that really move and move without the basketball. I would love for the league to go back to where a guy can have a touch or a balance of touching
Come on,
somebody.
Get it.
Being able to guard somebody without touching at all, that is very hard.
I think most players would agree with you.
You just want to be able to touch to get a little balance.
Sure. Hayward grabs the board.
They can't buy one right now. 0-4 already. All right. To start the third.
Here's LaVine. 8 points for him. Third quarter of basketball, about a minute and a half in. Lopez kicks to LaVine. Here's Mirotić. That's good, and it's LaVine with the assist. LaVine's got his fourth
that
assist
guy
in
shoot.
This one. Boston's gone 7-15 from three-point range tonight. They're not afraid of that shot. Foul called that time on the way up. That'll give him two chances at the free throw line here.
Nice work to get it inside.
Let's do this.
And you think back to just a few years ago when the Bulls were winning the East. That team, core of Rose, Noah, and Dane, had some tough luck not to make it to the finals.
Yes.
And with those Rose-led Bulls teams from a few seasons back, it all went south so fast. But those teams were very tough to beat.
Got
it
both.
Just shows
all
you
right.
How much can change in the NBA in a short span. Bulls are working hard to try to get back to that level. It hasn't been an easy road.
There's the pass to Pondexter. Lopez, a screen on Hayward. And he dunks it after the pick frees him up.
Lopez knows how to make himself as wide as possible and bury the defender with a screen.
Horford the pass to the monster. Lopez with the steal.
Turnover. I didn't even have it in my hands.
Here's Pondexter.
I guess I did.
Great positioning on the putback.
Let's go, team. Come on.
And the road back into this game wasn't a short one, but they've managed to make it all the way back and tie this thing up.
Well, this team, they trust each other. Even down big, they have the ability to come back, and they have so far.
Irving double team. Lopez with the steal, and even three-on-three break. Okay, well, let's check in with David Aldridge, who's reporting from the sidelines.
Kevin, Celtics coach Brad Stevens is known for getting the best out of his players. He said every NBA player has an elite strength. Some of them have 10 of them. And those guys are the very best in the league, right? But every one of them is here for a reason. And there are times when you can really soar with that skill. Kevin?
And that's why Stevens is already one of the best coaches in the league, David. You've talked about him for a long time. Getting maximum results from every one of his players. Dishes it to Horford. He feeds it to Irving. Celtics passing it around. Fires the three. Good, and Smart gets the assist.
All right.
Smart's got three assists tonight.
They're doing work here in the second half. 3 or 4 to start.
Just over 3.5 minutes through the third quarter of play now. Off the screen.
The creativity.
Should have hacked the hell out of that guy.
You see why Zach's won the dunk contest multiple times.
And that was Under Armour bringing you that replay. Unleash chaos. And what a play it was. So for the Bulls, Felicio comes in for Robin.
Okay, we're up by 3. When I come back in, what's it going to be? Up by 2. All right.
The Celtics have gone 5 of 7 from the field in the third quarter. Let's see if they can keep it up. And the wide open shot from Morris, kept alive by Boston, kicks it to Wells.
Come on, Shammy.
All right. For two. Wells has got 11 points.
How many First times have we game. Seen a possession like that from them today? Ending with a basket, coming off a pretty pass.
Pondexter kicks to Markkanen. How good on the three. Celtics leading by 4. Brown wide open. He fires. Here's Morris. And
all right.
The whistle, so he'll have a 3-point play opportunity.
And when he's aggressive, watch out. Morris finishing through the contact, now going to the line to try and add one more.
Valentine's checked in for the Bulls.
Marcus Morris, a stretch four out of Kansas, has a good shot from range and can stretch out
a
defense.
Dude, it's all right.
Not your typical power forward.
And with Marcus Morris, his role when he's out on the floor is to stretch a defense and pull a big away from the basket, and he accomplishes that.
Yeah, he takes a good amount of threes, and you don't mind it. He's a solid shooter from deep at his position. Teams need a big man who can shoot like him to open things up.
Rozier kicks to Brown. There's a good screen. Morris with the ball. 8 points for him. Over Levine. Again, the miss by the Celtics.
Yeah, you love the solid screen, but what you hate is just the inability to finish.
You can see he's frustrated with that one. Nose is up to him to make that play.
Wells kicks to Brown. Pass to Rozier. To the middle. It's stolen.
God bless it.
The Bulls fast break. Here's Valentine. That misses. Had a chance to tie it there.
Uh-oh. He misses the bunny. I think he thought somebody was coming over to contest it.
They get the rebound.
Jimmy!
Wells' shot
all
is
right.
Good. 13 points in the game.
Yeah, like the edge. Wells.
All right, Jimmy. All right.
Terrific at judging misses and then just pouncing on the boards.
Here's Portis. They look to him for part of their offensive attack. Right now, he averages nearly 12 points a game. Clock at six. Now, here's Valentine. Misses off the right iron.
20th rebound, man.
Here's Rozier. He hasn't scored yet. That, I'm sure, will change. The kick out to Brown. Over to the left wing. Here's the monster. Felicio with the rebound. Felicio's got rebound number five.
I do not have
tonight.
The touch on anything unless I'm in close.
Levine gets the 3-pointer to fall.
Let's go, guys. Come on.
17 now.
Watch out. Now that he's got his first three of the half, there might be more in store.
Rozier kicks to Brown. On the wing, Morris. And that one goes out of bounds. Last touch by Levine. And it's time for a look at our rookie leaderboard to see which rookies have been the most dangerous scorers in the league.
All right, I'm getting
over
up there.
The last 10 games. When you look at the monster, second in the league, having an excellent season.
And, you know, they've given him some more responsibility offensively in these past 2 weeks. He's responded.
Abrines the pass to the monster. Nice pass, nice catch, and a resounding dunk.
Fundamentals, guys.
The coach likes pick and roll. Pick and roll.
Makes the basics look pretty exceptional.
Whoa. Oh, my own guy blocked me.
Thrown down hard with both hands.
Shoot. Sorry.
Aggressive move.
Here you go, Shammy.
Fantastic finish.
Trying to send a message with that slam, I think. Brown kicks to Wells. There's a good screen. Nailed
you,
from
yeah.
Land.
All right, Shammy.
Wells has got seven now in this quarter.
Well, if you wonder why they're
in control, get out of my way.
Just look at his stats from the field. Solid, solid, solid.
Here's Grant. Rebounded by the monster.
Wow, I can't believe he missed that one.
He's just not on his game, no doubt about it. Their deficit isn't totally on him, but he has not been an asset for his team. And when Wells spots one of his guys wide open, doesn't hesitate at all. Just gets it over before the D can react.
Knocked loose. Here's Felicio.
No.
It doesn't
give me that.
For him. Some solid defense there from the monster. Coach is liking what he's seeing from his offense.
And guys, they put the defense on the defensive.
Bulls trail by six. Markkanen dishes to Grant.
All right.
With a 6-point lead at the end of the quarter. And the 3-point shot has been big for him. We'll return shortly. for Chicago.
Come in with,
and he's checked in for Mirotić. And Levine
left.
Subbed in for Grant. And then for Boston. The monster comes in for Marcus Morris. And
back
Smart
on Lopez.
Subbed in for Alex Abrines. We've got Robin Lopez, Quincy Pondexter out there with Zach Levine. Then there's Markkanen. And it's Portis in at the four. So that's the five in the game for Chicago. Payne passes to Markkanen. The Bulls need to get a shot off here.
Oh my God.
Get it back. Lopez kicks to Pondexter.
Where am I going?
With the clock winding down, and Lopez throws it down.
You love the way Robin Lopez just goes
okay.
After those missed shots. That's where he
damn
can
it,
do
man.
Damage.
Feeds it to Smart. In the corner, it's Hayward. Nice ball movement by Boston. And there's Horford. That's good on the assist by Irving.
Here we go.
Irving's got
three.
His fourth assist with that last one here tonight. Bulls trail by eight. Guys are looking for a spark here.
Yeah, a cold stretch offensively, for sure.
Levine dishes to Markkanen over Irving.
No, get out of here.
Another rebound hauled in. They're hitting the glass with a lot of passion.
Hayward.
Oh, you gotta be kidding me, man.
Lopez. Lopez has got his seventh rebound of the game with that last one. Here's Levine.
No.
And so he draws the foul on the shot on trip to the line.
Okay.
Two. And certainly while the injury for Zach Levine and his ACL was devastating, Greg, it's good to see him back on the court, and he seems to be on track to making a full recovery.
And Kevin, still amazing to me to see just how far the medical community has come in terms of treating ACL injuries. Levine is such an athletic monster. To lose even a little burst would have been huge. Fortunately, though, with modern medicine, it's going to allow this guy to make
most
of his potential.
Cold.
Still.
Grant against Irving. Grant the pass to Levine. A stupendous finish in traffic.
Thought I had it. Thought I could have blocked
that. Both sides are really battling. Zach Levine right in the middle of it, wanting to take charge.
Smart with the ball. Now defended by Levine. Got a piece of it. And so it looks like the Celtics will retain possession here. Mirotić is checked in for Bobby Portis.
Nikola Mirotić.
Here is Hayward. Pass to the monster. Shot clock at six.
And one.
Good, and he'll get a chance for one more at the free throw line.
Yeah, outstanding right. Job there of taking the harm and still able to finish.
The free throw.
Get it. Oh, first miss.
Bulls trail by six. Lopez, a screen on Irving. Inside and stolen by Horford. And pushing it up. Here's Boston. Here's Hayward. Yes, and it's Irving picking up the assist. Hayward's got 12 points now in the quarter.
Hayward is just automatic from the mid-range area. Can't let him get comfortable from there.
Lopez a screen. Down low, there's Levine. Arms length from the hoop, he knocks it down. Levine's
come on,
got 15
man.
Points here in the second half.
And you don't want to allow too many of those short ones with the game right now in the balance.
Here's the monster.
Get it.
Jams it with authority.
Yeah, and give it up for the feed from Horford. He's a playmaker, and you love having a big man show off that kind of vision.
Grant against Irving. Mirotić the screen. Levine for three. Again,
give me that
Levine
board.
Missing. They can burn some clock if they want to.
And get a little breather as well.
In the corner, it's Hayward. And there's the pass to the monster. He kicks to Horford. Right wing. Six on the shot clock. And Levine comes to help. For three, Hayward. Hayward missing again.
Just enough coverage to bother that three-point attempt.
Lopez a screen. Grant with the ball. Guarded now by Irving. Levine can't hit.
In
20.
The second half, the defense 24. Had been faded
I thought I had 25.
And we're seeing why.
passes it to the monster. In the corner, it's Hayward. Shot from the wing. They grab their own miss.
Here's my 25th board.
There's 37 seconds left in the fourth quarter.
Oh, I do that.
To the wing right side. The monster passes to Hayward. To the middle. Out left to the wing.
Why do I keep passing? Smart. Give me that board, damn it.
And it's the Bulls with the
ball. Okay.
Trailing here by eight. Pondexter kicks to Miritich. Money! Oh, and that cuts the lead to just five.
The game was up for grabs, and Miritich comes up with a bang. Just a sensational score in these types of situations.
We're in a heck of a... Okay.
Here's Wells, and now we've got the intentional foul.
Denzel Valentine. That's his second person.
Okay.
At the line in the summer. Shen Wells.
So the first one drops, and that increases their lead to six.
That's a lock right there, man. Make sure that's seven.
To the floor. It becomes infectious, that energy. It gets his guys going in the right direction.
Chicago calls timeout. They're behind by seven. 9 seconds left to play here in the fourth. Guys, what do you think?
And this is what happens when you dig yourself a hole.
19 points, 25 rebounds.
You know, this part of the game.
I mean, what it says. I don't know. My
execution, the
percentage from the field was not too good today. Well, they gave me the player of the game. All right. The glass work is what's cleaning them boards.
Levine dishes to Pondexter. No good with the triple.
And that's the game. All right.
Celtics with the W.
Finished with an A-plus teammate grade. All right.
They really had to work.
Didn't get my 20 points, but
I mean, weaker teams
had 20-something rebounds. See the points here, man. World finishes only had the one. Pass one. That's my first points as a fast break. 26 rebounds. You gotta love that. We had the one block. That was a good one though. Hard hits. Good screens. 17 good screens, man. Goodness. 3 for 4 from the line. Good game there for me. Overall, point-wise. Moved my VC up some. I needed that. Points per game went up. Fans are up over 150,000. Team chemistry up. So, yeah.
Hey, DJ.
Hey.
Great game out there. Look, Shaq and the guys want to talk to you.
It's time for another interview.
Really?
Stand, yeah, right this way. Oh, stand here.
Okay.
And we'll get you set up.
Done it before.
Perfect.
Put on the magic headphones. And boom.
This is Shaq. Nice win you guys were able to get there. What mentality did you guys have down the stretch trying to hold on to that lead?
Oh, definitely.
That's a great question, Shaq. You know, I think we just did a great job of trusting each other to do what we had to do in order to secure the win. And nobody started playing hero ball, and we just built off every play until it carried us to the end. It felt really good to play some solid team basketball like that tonight.
That was a really good, solid answer.
Thank you.
Well, there you go. The player of the game. Okay, I think that is going to be it for this episode. If you liked the episode, leave a like. If you've not yet subscribed, I'd appreciate it if you would. And we'll catch you next time on SRD Plays a Noob, plays NBA 2K18. Thanks a lot. Bye.